This video is basically about what I'm doing next, which is repairing the rust hole on the rear quarter panel there. I decided to work on this as it's kind of, they're predicting, you know, on and off sprinkles, and it has sprinkled a couple times today, so I don't want to put the car out to do any sanding or painting on the fenders or whatnot. But I started making this template to repair the quarter panel here, and I think I got it to where I can cut this out of sheet metal and start forming it. Just untape it right here. You can kind of see what it'll look like on the sheet metal, and then I'll bend it to, you know, fit this, and then after it all fits good, I'll cut this out. I'll make the inner piece. Maybe I'll tack this piece on, make the inner piece, tack it in, and weld it all up, and strip the paint so I can put body filler. I want to strip the paint before I do any body filler, because paint stripper will soften body filler. The mark, the Sharpie mark there, is kind of where I'm going to cut out. I'm going to cut out right to down to here, replace all this. And I already made a panel. That fits the, matches the wheel well opening and fits everything pretty good. And once that's cut out, that'll fit flush up against there. I might have to tap that a little flatter, this edge here a little flatter with the body hammer. But I think that's going to fit and work out pretty good. So I'll get this one tacked on, then I'll work on the inner one. I gotta fix, you know, the inner wheel house in here. Now you can see in there, and you can see where the inner wheelhouse is a little rotted out, and I'll clean that up to grind that out. It's not, the inner wheelhouse isn't bad, it's just the edge. I think that it got water in through this edge, and that's what caused you know, moisture and stuff and dirt to collect down in here and rot this out. So this is all pretty much all, the outer skin's ready, so I'm going to clean this. I'm going to cut this out everywhere where you see rust, and then I'll fit the new piece on the outside and tack it in. Well, you know, tack it in solid. Then I'll make the inner piece, because in case if I have to, you know, if this piece needs to be bent in or out, it's easier to do it if it's just tacked, you know, to try and get everything to fit nice and right. And making this inner piece will be fairly easy compared to the outer piece. You know, it doesn't have to be picture perfect on the inner. It has to look nice, but it doesn't have to be exactly picture perfect. So that is the, I think that's a drain there. I was hammering a spot weld with a chiseler. I gotta bend that back up, but I'm gonna clean all that out, clean this up, clean all this out, and grind the surface rust, get as much of that cleaned up as possible in zinc chromate prime before I weld anything on here. Look at the piece I cut out. Just glob Bondo through the rust, that'll fix it. Maybe shove some dirt and leaves in there to keep the Bondo from falling through. Yeah, that just doesn't, Bondo over rust holes just does not work. I'm gonna start welding the quarter panel patch in. It's, you know, it's, the weather just isn't conductive to getting things out and painting, and it will be this weekend, but I'm not going to be able to do it this weekend. I have too many other things planned for the weekend, so I won't be able to paint. So it'll probably be the end of next week sometime before I can paint. In the meantime, I'm just going to plug away at this. So got the welder out and going to start tacking that up. That looks pretty darn good. Came out nice. Now I'm gonna fix this bit right in here. That'll be an easy repair. I'll make the panel, drain the paint off the wheel house, and weld it in. So you can kind of see, let me see if I can get this camera out of the light. But anyway, I just kind of make a cardboard template, and then I take this out. Fits pretty good in there, and I can bend the metal with the body hammer, but I can fold this out straight. That's what I need to cut out of sheet metal, and how I need to give it its rough bends, and then we'll work it in there and get it, work it with the body hammers, tack it in, body hammer a little here and there, and tack. And I got it fit in there pretty good. I'm going to clean the paint and clean it up the bare metal, reclamp it in, and start tacking it in. And I can work it with the body hammer as I tack it to make sure it all fits super nicely. All welded in. Now I just got a ton of grinding. I got to get this all ground out. You know, I put extra on here, but it'll probably be ground in a little bit. I'll use the molding as a guide, and I still have the old wheel well opening there, and I just spot welded through to the back piece in a few places, and we got that. So that's as solid as a rock, not going anywhere. Now I gotta grind all the welds out, and probably a little filler out here. And here I'll grind the welds out, and probably won't put any filler in here. I'll probably just a little seam sealer or something like that. It'll look fine. So next I'll probably tackle what little spots are there. A couple little tiny, I mean, that's really going to be nothing to do. And this is just going to be a bunch of grinding welds and a little bit of filler. And I'll do that in a separate video, though. You know, show. I'm going to end this video with that all welded up. I'm just going to clean some of the dust off the things. Everything's covered in just massive amounts of sanding dust. I'm probably going to, when I'm done with the car, just take it out and have to wash everything. I just wanted to get some of the heavy stuff off and just keep it a little cleaner. So when I'm throwing sheets on and off, the sheets rubbing on parts don't scratch them. So, you know, I'm just kind of just dusty. It's not, by any means, not greasy or dirty. It's dusty. I should show you some before and after. And see where the valve cover had been touched there before, and that can scratch it. So you use a wet towel to wipe it off, and it doesn't scratch it. So I'm going to just wipe everything off so it doesn't get scratched up. You know, I'm waiting on paint to cure up, and this is something I can do. Why that's happening. Just kind of keep everything nice. Trying to get down on the intake. That's a little tight in there. Anyway, that's just kind of going around, like I say. I'm not going to video it all. That looks a little better. Just a little cleanup now and then never hurts. So I'm calling it a day. If you like my video, definitely hit the like button. It certainly helps. And if you want to see this all fixed up and painted up and looking amazing, subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.